Praise the Lord, everyone. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to thank you for joining me for Tuesday's Daily Bible Study, coming from Charlene's Outreach Ministries. Our lesson for today is Rivers of Living Water. Rivers of Living Water come from John 7, verses 37 through 39. We have a wonderful lesson as we go to John to study on the rivers of living water that resides in each of us. Amen. This is a great lesson. Before we get started, I want to ask if anything you see it touches your heart, soul, or spirit. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to jot them at the bottom of the screen below, and I will get to them as soon as possible. Also, if you would like prayer, please give me your name, and I will add you to the prayer list. If you want to send a message, you can send it to God's Hand at Work at charlenesoutreachministries.com. Praise the Lord. Also, subscribe to the channel and join with us as we study together to meditate and grow stronger in the Word of the Lord. As He said in His Word, that we are to meditate on His Word day and night. And I try to give us something fresh and new to begin our day with as we go forward. Amen. We're going to have prayer, then we're going to move right into the lesson. Dear God in heaven, we do thank You. We thank You, Father, for all that You have done, You is doing, and You shall do. We give You honor, glory, and praise. Lord, we thank You for waking us up this morning, starting us on our way. We thank You for all that You do in our life, all the things that you bless us and You guide us and lead us. We thank You, Father, that You are so wonderful to us. We thank You, Father, for being with us as we go through our trials and tribulations, as we deal with our inner problems, our strengthening problems, our mind problems. Lord, we thank You that You are with us and You guide us and You are there for us at all times, giving us peace of mind in all situations as we come to You. Father, we give You honor, glory, and praise. Lord, we thank You at this time that You open our eyes that we see and our ears that we hear, and give us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding from on high, that we may be more proficient doers of Your word and not hearers only, that we may go forth and be the person that You would have others to see. Let them see You through each of us as we go forth in our life. We give You honor, glory, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, we're going to move right into our wonderful lesson. Rivers of Living Water, coming from John 7, verses 37 through 39. We have a short lesson this morning. And the scripture lesson text read, "In the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this speak he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive, for the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified." Amen. This is a powerful and wonderful lesson, as we see Jesus Christ himself is speaking to us, because we have now that opportunity to receive that living water. We receive that living water when we receive Him. Amen. And as we grow in our faith and grow in our walk with God, then it grows and it becomes more and more powerful in our life. Amen. It's such a wonderful lesson we have. Now, this lesson I want to bring out is one of the reasons that you be mindful as you use your different versions of scripture. I love the ESV version, but it says that out of your heart shall flow rivers of living water. And I did not find that to be biblical as far as the wording, as far as the translations from the Greek to the Hebrew, to my understanding. But I go on what I understand, and that's all I can go on. And so I thank God that we did notice that difference. And so we want to make sure that we pay attention to the, you know, small differences that is in the different translations of the scripture as we are studying our word. I see no harm in reaching out to other versions that we may get a better understanding of the word, but let us make sure that it is staying in context with what the scripture is saying. Amen. And it is a powerful statement that out of our belly, the innermost being of us, that the living water, the living word comes from deep within us. Amen. Because many times our heart strays us away into places we don't need to go. But if we go from our belly, we're going from the inner core, that we can go forward and do the will of the Lord. Amen. And direct our heart in the way that it should go. Change, because many times, as you know, as an example, as young women and men, as we're coming up, many times we fall in, as they say, in love with the wrong person, and they are not good for us. They are not, you know, the right person for us. And we have to rearrange our thinking and rearrange our thought pattern, because even when they are doing harm to us, many times people will stay because they're following their heart, and many times that is not the way to go. So we want to follow the Holy Spirit by following the unction of the Holy Spirit as it comes through us, and as the living water comes out of our belly shall flow rivers of living water. Amen. Commentary says, on the last day of the Feast of the Tabernacle, the Jews drew water and poured it out before the Lord. It was supposed that Christ alluded to this. If any man desires to be truly and forever happy, let him apply to Christ, or have the joy of the Lord within them, and be ruled by him. This thirst means strong desires after spiritual blessings, which nothing else can satisfy. So the sanctifying and comforting influence of the Holy Spirit were intended by the waters which Jesus called on them to come to him and drink. The comfort flows plentifully and constantly as a river, strong as a stream to bear down the opposition of doubts and fears. If we will step forward, if we will open our mouth, the Holy Spirit will speak through us, and out of our belly we shall flow rivers of living water. Amen. There is a fullness in Christ of grace for grace. The Spirit dwelling and working in believers is a fountain of living, running water, out of which plentiful streams flow, cooling and cleansing as water. The miraculous gifts of the Holy Spirit we do not expect, but for his more common and more valuable influences we may apply. These streams have flowed from our glorified Redeemer down to this age and to the remote corners of the earth. May we be anxious to make them known to others, that out of our belly flows rivers of living water. As we open our mouth and as we meditate on his word day and night, as we do so, then what's in do come out. Amen. So what the man speaks is what's within him. Amen. So as we put the word in us, and then out of our belly comes the living water that God has given us. Amen. And the Holy Spirit gives us the correct word to say at the right time for the right season. Amen. I pray you meditate on this great and wonderful lesson, and you all have a wonderful and blessed day today. Praise the Lord.